Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, and I'm here at ACTRIMS 2017 in the poster session. And at the poster sessions, we sometimes hear about new research that's going on, not just in terms of the pathophysiology of MS or where MS comes from, but also potentially something that can help us symptomatically with treatment. And that's why I'm so happy to be joined here by Dr. Jeff Cohen, who is the director of the Mellen MS Center at the Cleveland Clinic Foundation in Cleveland, Ohio. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good to see you again.
You're here with a poster that has to do with a product that's new but old at the same time. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Right, so amantadine is a drug that's been available for quite a while. We use it in MS typically to treat fatigue. So this is a new formulation of amantadine that allows us to administer higher doses. It's shown a lot of promise in treating DOPA-induced dyskinesias. But there also were some preliminary data that might be beneficial in treating symptoms of MS. So what this study was examining was the ability of this formulation of amantadine to improve walking-related impairment. So walking speed, functional mobility as measured by the timed up and go test, and walking endurance as measured by a two-minute walk. And so this is an indication that, for example, dalfampridine currently has. It's an effective drug. Unfortunately, it only works in about a third of patients. Mm-hmm. So we were actually quite excited by these results, showing a very robust benefit on walking speed, mobility, walking endurance, that was demonstrable for the group as a whole.
So you'd have to use a responder analysis
idea. Exactly. So we were able to see a benefit with the whole group, suggesting it's a much more consistent benefit, perhaps a more potent benefit.
What are some of the potential side effects?
So this was actually quite well tolerated. The main side effects have been sleep disturbance, paresthesias, very rarely libido radicularis, things that have been seen with amantadine. One of the advantages is that we have quite a lot of experience with amantadine over the years for MS, Parkinson's disease, to treat influenza. So there were very few surprises in terms of safety and tolerability. So that's actually very encouraging.
Now, the FDA is looking at this medication soon or right now, having to do with what you mentioned about DOPA-induced dyskinesia, so having to do with more of the Parkinson's world. Where are we going with MS? What's going to happen next?
So the studies in Parkinson's are underway. The plan at MS is, first of all, to do a phase 3 study looking at walking. Mm-hmm. There's also reason to think that this would work for other symptoms. There's probably nothing magic about walking impairment. It's probably the same mechanisms cause impairment of dexterity, cognition, vision, eye movements. So we'll probably look at those other endpoints as exploratory endpoints. And then the other aspect is that amantadine also has some neuroprotective effects. Mm-hmm. So that's probably further down the road that we'll look at that. Potentially this could be a neuroprotective strategy.
You mentioned mechanism. What do you think the mechanism is by which it works here?
So the neuroprotective mechanisms are probably through glutamate.
Okay.
The mechanism for this, I think, is at the moment not completely understood, why it would work this quickly. So that's something that's going to have to be studied in the laboratory.
Well, I want to thank you so much for joining us, and I want to thank you for joining us at home.